Thank you for visiting this video segment for Dr. AFib. I'm Dr. Morales. In today's video segment, we're going to be talking about smoking and atrial fibrillation and how the effects of smoking can influence your atrial fibrillation. So smoking is the most common cause of preventable illness worldwide. Smoking causes many health conditions. It can cause lung disease, heart disease, circulation issues, and also several types of cancers. But in 2018, it was found that it is also a significant risk factor for developing atrial fibrillation. There was a European study that was published in 2018, which was a meta-analysis, which means that they took a combination of several different studies put together and studied over 600,000 patients and found that there is a significant increase in the risk of atrial fibrillation for people who smoke. People who smoked had a 32% risk for developing atrial fibrillation. And even people who used to smoke or had a formerly a smoker still had a 9% risk for developing atrial fibrillation. But probably one of the most significant data noted from this was found that not just smoking by itself causes atrial fibrillation, but the amount of people smoked had an increased risk for developing atrial fibrillation. And so the more that somebody smoked, the higher that risk of developing atrial fibrillation. For example, for people who smoked 10 cigarettes a day, the risk of developing atrial fibrillation was 17%. For 20 cigarettes a day, it was 32%. And if you smoked 30 cigarettes a day, that risk went up to 45% risk for developing atrial fibrillation. So there was a significant increase for every 10 cigarettes that you smoke a day, that risk of developing atrial fibrillation. Now, is it just the cigarettes themselves or the effects that the cigarettes can also have on somebody's body? Smoking appears to influence atrial fibrillation, but it also affects people getting lung conditions such as COPD and emphysema, heart disease such as coronary artery disease, and all of these can influence developing atrial fibrillation. But this is one of the best and clear data that showed the more you smoke, the higher your risk for developing atrial fibrillation. And it certainly showed an improvement when people quit smoking. And so quitting smoking is good for people for many reasons, for lung disease, heart disease, and for atrial fibrillation. And so I know it's easier said than done to quit smoking. People take many tries sometimes to be able to quit smoking. But fortunately, there's a lot of options out there for people to be able to aid their cessation of smoking, whether that be gums, medications, or some people say even just the cold turkey stop smoking, it tends to have the best long-term results. So either one of those methods can be useful, but it's also good to know that, or good to understand that it sometimes takes many tries and many efforts for people to be successful at smoking cessation. Thank you for visiting this video segment for Dr. AFib. I'll see you next time.